Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. The concept of data types is something that stretches beyond programming languages. Other technologies, such as database technologies, also incorporates concepts of data types. Let's now take our basic knowledge of data types and apply it to Django and the databases that Django interacts with. Data needs to conform to certain rules for it to be useful in our application. Let's just take this random form that I found. Imagine we were going to replicate this form with Django. So we created a web page which had a form, and we then specified all these inputs into that form. Now let's just take the mobile phone here. We want to make a form which prevents users from adding data into an entry, into an input that doesn't apply or isn't relevant to that particular information. So let's just take the mobile phone here. We all know that the mobile phone is made up of a certain amount of numbers. We would most probably want to develop this form to prevent users from entering letters in this particular input, in the mobile phone input. One way in which we can enforce these rules is by remembering that this data will eventually be stored in a database. Each of these specific elements or inputs or data values will be stored individually in individual fields inside of our database. The data in our database may look a little bit like this. So for each row would represent a new entry in our database. We would have different field names, and inside of our fields here, we would have values that represent the field. So for example here, this field name is name, so the data that will represent name would most probably be characters, such as letters. So the name Xander. Age, we would probably want to represent that with a number, a whole number. So you can start to see and infer that potentially will be an integer type of data. So we have the mobile phone, which should only include numbers. At the database level, we can start to enforce these type of rules and use the idea of data types to then specify what data can be stored in each field. Django allows us to build tables and specify which data should be included or should be allowed in each of those fields. If we go over to the Django documentation model field reference, what we have here, if we move down on the right-hand side, I'm looking, we have something called field types. So the concepts here are very similar to data types. We're going to build this simple table here. So if we were going to build this table, we would need to specify the data type or the field type that we want to include for each of these fields. And that will be dependent upon the data we want to store within this particular field. So let's go for the name field here. So this is going to be some sort of text field. So let's take a look to see what we have available. So if we take a look at the field types here, we have something called a character field. So if I click on that, you can see that this character field is for a string. So this is a string field for small or large size strings. These field types follow the same rules as our data types in Python, in that it specifies the field type here, or what we can also call a data type here for our database. It specifies the value that can be entered into our field. And it also will, in other data types, specify the expectations and what can be performed on that particular field, because we have something, if we look up the top here, called options. And we have different options that we can define for potentially different field types. So for the age field and for the mobile field, those are both number field only. So let's take a look at what field we have available. So this is a case of just becoming familiar and just browsing over and why I'm showing you this. So you can access this and browse over the fields that are available. So let's go back into our numbers here. So that isn't necessarily self-explanatory, but there is a field here called integer field. So we click on that. We are told that we can store numbers within this range successfully. So we can probably determine that the age and the telephone field will be specified as an integer field. Just reading through some of these different field types, some of them are quite self-explanatory just by reading the name. So for example, date field, date time field. So if we need to store the date or the date time, we have something there specific for that. We have a specific field here for email field. So that's pretty handy, because likely that this field will perform some sort of validation check on the data before it's inserted. So we all know that an email address has an at symbol. So it's very likely that this email field will perform certain validation on our data before then it's inserted into that field, ensuring that the user is actually typing in a valid email address, at least to a certain extent. So we have a file field for files, an image field, maybe for storing references to images. And then we also have a JSON field. So if we wanted to store JSON notation code within a field, we could do that too. Now, while we're here, we do have some other more specific field types. For example, you notice we have the auto fields. So if we just drill down to the big auto field here, it actually gives us a better understanding of what exactly this is. This is a 64-bit integer, so a very big number, and it's expected that it is guaranteed to fit numbers from 1 to this very large number here. So an auto field generally is utilized in Django to automatically increment a number in our table. So just going back to our table here, if you're not familiar with databases and tables, there is something called a primary key, and that's a unique identifier which we can use to uniquely identify this row here, this piece of data. So every time we add new data into our database, we want to sometimes add a unique identifier automatically. So the auto fields allow us to automatically increment the number every time we enter data into the database without having to then specify this number. So if I were to add some new data into this database now, this database table, sorry, then this ID would increment 1 to 2, and then so on and so on, depending on the amount of data that I then add into the database. Don't worry if that doesn't make sense. We'll take a look at that when we start to build a table. Now, it's highly recommended that you spend just a little bit of time familiarizing yourself with some of the different field types, or at least have this handy. When you start to build your tables in Django, just have this handy to help you identify a correct or preferred field type to utilize for the specific type of data you want to include or store in your fields.